So in the previous video, we looked at what the stabilizer is of an element of a set when we act with the set of a group onto that element. And I want to show you a tangible example. And it's a type of a group that we haven't looked at before specifically, but I'm going to just do that. I'm going to take a square, so a square, that side equals that side, all the angles 90 degrees. I'm going to call this corner 1, corner 2, corner 3, corner 4, with side 1, side 2, side 3, and side 4. And I'm going to have diagonal 1, and I'm going to have diagonal 2. Oops, diagonal 2. You see that? And let's just think about, if we fix certain points, how can we rotate this thing? And we're going to call row 0 is I do nothing to it, and that's going to be our identity element. Row 1 is I stick a pin there, and I rotate it anti-clockwise by 90 degrees. So 1 goes to 2, 3 goes to 4, 4, you know, it turns around like that. So that is just the identity element. I'm going to rotate counterclockwise by pi over 2. Row 2 is I'm going to rotate by 180 degrees. Row 3 is 3 pi over 2, so 270 degrees. Mu 1 is what I'm going to do with mu 1. I'm going to flip it around a certain axis. Let's flip it around, let's say, for our example here, I'm going to say, let's just do that as vertical. So I'm going to flip it around that axis. So I keep it like that, and I flip it around that axis. And mu 2 is I'm going to flip it around this axis. So I go up, and I'm going to have d1. Let's have d1 is I stick it there, and I flip it around that axis. And d2, I flip it around that axis. So d1 I drew this way, d3 that way. So, I mean, you can mix these two up. But for now, let's just imagine that that is our picture. So I'm going to suggest that I have my group. It's actually called D4. It's a group, and it has these elements, row 0, row 1, sorry, row 2, row 3, mu 1, mu 2, and delta 1 and delta 2. And I have my binary operation is that I have this composition of two of these. So first I rotate clockwise 90 degrees, and then I flip around that axis. So I'm not going to prove that for you, Cayley's table, that this is a group. Let's just take for granted that it is a group. And my set A is just going to be my sides, my corners 1, 2, 3, 4, my sides, side 1, side 2, side 3, side 4, and my diagonals 1 and my diagonal 2. So that's what I have. And now let's just look at the stabilizer of corner 1. Which one of these elements in my group, of the set that makes up my group, will stabilize 1? That I can do any one of these and 1 will stay where it is. Definitely row 0. Row 0 is going to be everywhere. Remember, we proved that this is a subgroup, so it's got to be a group in its own right. So the identity element is there. What else will keep D1 in its place? Well, if I fix those two points and I just flip along there, so along this line, so D2, or I should not call that, I should have called that delta 2, delta 1 and delta 2. So definitely flipping around delta 2 is going to do that for me. And those are the only two under that binary operation as well. So those two, just keeping it on D2 and flipping it there, is going to do that for me. Let's take side number 3. What is going to keep side number 3 there? Again, the identity element. But what about if I fix it along this axis here and I just flip it around? Now S3 turns around, but S3 is still exactly where it is. So definitely mu 1 is going to be my other element. And so I have an identity element. It is those two will be the inverses of each other. So let's just look at, well, this one is its own inverse, and that's its own inverse, I should really say. Let's now look at a more complicated one. Let's keep diagonal one in its place. Well, first of all, row will be there, but what if I just were to keep it there and flip it around itself? It will still be there, so definitely delta 1 will be there. If I do this, delta 2, and I flip it around there, D will flip around, but it is still just where it is. So definitely delta 2 will be there. And let's just think of another one. If I just were to look at it, and I were to rotate it through pi over 2 and another pi over 2, it stays there. It's upside down, but it's still there where it is. So row 2 there is also going to be. So have a look at this beautiful example. Take my word for it that that is a group, and see if you agree with the stabilizers of, we looked at that element, we looked at side 3, and we looked at diagonal 1. See if you agree with what the stabilizers are of those three elements of this set, just to help you understand of cement what a stabilizer is.